Hi there. So the folks at Ulanzi asked me to review their Ulanzi and Coman Zero Y lightweight travel tripod. And I'm going to take you through the features and take it out and put the tripod through its paces to test it. Now, these views are entirely my own. They've not asked me to say anything. They've not paid me to say anything. Although those of you who are eagle-eyed may have noticed something pop up to say paid promotion. I'll come back to that later. But firstly, let's get into the tripod. So it comes here in this rather nice box. So let's get it out of that, because at the end of the day, a box doesn't get you a nice photo. And inside it, you'll find this canvas carry case. And again, you know, that's nice to have, but canvas cases don't get you great photos. And to be honest, I very rarely see anybody take a tripod out in a carry case. Most people strap it to their camera bags. But if you're into carry cases, this is a rather nice one. So let's get the tripod out. Actually, before we get to the tripod, in the box you get a strap that you can carry your carry case over your shoulder if you like. And there are also a little bag of spikes. Now, they're really useful because, as I've mentioned in videos before, spikes can be really good if you're on soft ground or somewhere a little bit slippy like ice. You can use the spikes to dig into the ground and stop that tripod moving. And typically, for a pair of decent spikes, you'll pay between £10 and £50. The best ones you'll find are probably nearer the £50 mark. So to get these free is a nice little bonus. But let's go through the features of the tripod. So it's super lightweight. And that was the thing that struck me as soon as I received this, just how lightweight this is. It's 1.1 kilograms. Which is so lightweight, and the legs are carbon fiber, the center column is aluminium, and all the clips on it are plastic, but they're really strong plastic. And on the website it says that all the parts are serviceable and guaranteed for life, so that is a great bonus. You'll see here that we've got these ratchets on the legs, which is a nice feature. So in order to move the legs, you just push the button down, lift it up, and then it ratchets down to each of the next spots. And you can have leg angles at 75%, 55%, and 25% to get flat to the ground. You've got this little lever that pulls up and allows you to raise and lower the center column. Now, in all honesty, I've been a little bit worried about this center column because it's triangular. And normally with center columns, they're circular. So you get pressure 360 degrees around it and friction 360 degrees around the circular center column, stopping it moving. With this one, the pressure points, when you push that lever down, hold the tripod in at the three points of the triangle. So there's a lot less pressure points on it holding it in place. So I'm really going to test this center column and push it to see if it's any good. Now, it's got four extendable sections and it can reach a maximum height of 156 centimeters. It can get as low as 15.3 centimeters. And there are a number of different ways that you can move this ball on the ball head around. So firstly, you'll see there's this little lever here that you turn, and that allows you just to turn the disc, so to pan around with it. Now, I don't find this lever particularly useful, to be honest, because your camera sits over it. So you're going to mount it either on this directly or with something like an L bracket or a camera cage. And then your camera's sat over that lever. So I found it a little bit fiddly to get to that lever. You've also got this knob that turns that allows you to take out the plate or put in your own camera cage or L bracket. And then you've got this lever that allows you to move the ball head in any direction. So next, if you don't use a camera cage or an L bracket, it's really easy to be able to shoot in portrait format, because as you lift this lever, you can tip the ball head down to one side, and you can actually do it both ways. So you can tip the ball head 180 degrees in the opposite direction. So it is really easy to get into portrait orientation with this. However, I would recommend that you use an L bracket or a camera cage, because you can do it so quickly just by flipping your camera around. Now, in order to get down to ground level, when you spread those legs right out like that, you need to actually remove the center column. and the centre column comes in two sections. And it's a really clever little solution. So at the bottom of the centre column, you've got this little hook that undoes, and that hook has an Allen key in the end. So that Allen key can be useful if you want to tighten up the legs, but it's also for removing the larger portion of the centre column. So how you do it is you flip the ball head into portrait orientation, and there's a hole in there. You put the Allen key down and turn it, and the lower part of the centre column comes out. So we're going to try that later to see how quick it is to actually do, because it appears to me to be a little bit of a faff. However, that being said, this is a really clever solution, but does clever always mean good? Let's find out. So firstly, I want to put this tripod through its paces, and I'm going to start by testing out those spikes. So join me on a slippy slope. Okay, so it's just before sunset, and I've got two of my favourite hills just over here, hopefully going to get the sun setting in between them. And sorry if you can hear sheep, I'm surrounded by them, so there's not a lot I can do. But you can see I am on a hill here, and the grass is really slippy because in the days before this we've had quite a lot of rain. So in order to give myself that little bit more stability, I'm going to try these spikes and see if they work very well and how it anchors the tripod into the ground. What I'm going to use the tripod for in this test is to do a time lapse of the sun setting between those two hills. So it'll be really telling when we come to stitch all of those photos together into a video to make that time lapse to see if there's any movement in between shots. Because often, if you do have a tripod that's not particularly stable, you may have to align some of your photos. If I don't have to align any, then that means this tripod has stayed perfectly still. So let's give it a go. It didn't quite turn out to be the sunset I'd hoped for, with that band of cloud across the horizon blocking out the sun, but there are still some interesting things in it. I like the sheep moving around in the bottom left-hand corner, and being a stone's throw from Manchester Airport meant there were loads of planes in the sky. But back to the tripod. I haven't aligned any of these images, and if I put a dot at the top of each summit of those hills, you'll see there was no movement whatsoever. Also, watch out for some people descending from the summit of the first hill. So, with those spikes in the ground and on a wet slope, that tripod did not move at all. Okay, so today I want to test the centre column here and how stable it really is. And I'm going to be testing it using this brook that's running alongside me. It's about 2 miles long and it's got cascades all the way down it. So I'm going to go for a walk, find a composition I've never photographed before because I've photographed here quite a lot. And I'm going to try two things. One with the camera hanging down from the centre column and one with the centre column right up. I probably actually don't need to do that to get the photos that I want to get or to get the type of photos that I want to get. But this is just a test to see how good this centre column is and if it can be stable. Thank you. So, with a reversed centre column, that tripod held my camera perfectly well and was very stable. With a long exposure shot, you want to see some motion in the water, but the test really is how sharp and in focus everything around the water is. And here you'll see that the trees and the rocks are perfectly sharp, even with a 4 second shutter speed. So next, let's try the center column extended upwards. I've got my 70 to 180 millimeter lens on here, which is much heavier than the camera and lens combination I used for the previous shot. I'm just aiming at a particular rock to see if there's any difference when zoomed in to a specific feature. And you'll see that all the detail in the rock, the mosses, and the water flowing over it, it doesn't get sharper than this. However, there is some motion in that center column. Let me show you pressing the shutter in slow motion, and you can see here that there's a little bit of a wobble after I let go of the camera. But by using a 5 second self timer, any motion has stopped by the time the picture is taken. So one thing I've not tested is getting this tripod flat to the ground. And so I'm going to do a timed comparison now with my three-legged thing bookie and see which you can get to the ground fastest. So let's start with the Ulanzi. And if I can set a timer, please. And go. So first thing I'm going to do is undo this hook at the bottom of the center column to take out the Allen key. And then I'm going to raise the center column up like that and put the tripod to one side, tilt the ball head down and insert the Allen key inside the hole in the top of the ball head. And I just need to find the hole inside there. It's a little bit fiddly, but I just keep turning and it's going to take quite a few turns to get the bottom part of the center column off. But eventually you'll see it does come off. We're not there yet, although it feels like it's nearly at the point where it's off. So I'm just going to keep on turning and turning and going to keep talking because we're still turning. But eventually this should come off. There we go. It's out. So let's put that to one side, put the ball head back the right way up, insert it into the tripod and fasten that, then raise the legs to the highest position and on the ground stop the clock. So next let's do the same thing with Bookie. So let's set another timer for Bookie and go. So I'm going to take off the screw at the bottom of Bookie's center column, put that to one side, undo the center column and remove it entirely. That's nice and easy. Take off the ball head. And there we go. That's just about off. Let's put the center column to one side and we'll put the ball head back on top of the tripod. You'll notice that Bookie has got similar ratchets on the legs to raise them. Put those into position and done. Stop the clock. So, I've tipped the Bookie upside down. So, I don't know which of those was fastest because I've not seen the clock. I've got a feeling it was Bookie, but who knows? You'll see those numbers on the screen right now. Which was fastest? Which was more fiddly? I'll leave that for you to decide. So I just wanted to have one more shot at sunset for this video, probably because the first one I did with that time lapse didn't work out very well because of those clouds. And tonight's looking like it could be the same. There's some clouds in the distance, but I'm keeping my fingers crossed that those clouds separate a little bit, because if they do, the colours should erupt. And I'm at Winners Pass, which is one of my favourite locations. There are so many different compositions here, and I've shown photos from this place in videos before. I'll stick a few of them on the screen now whilst we're waiting for sunset. There's about half an hour to go. A few of these you might not have seen before because I've never posted them on YouTube, but this is a fantastic location and it's another great opportunity to test this tripod. So let's just keep our fingers crossed for sunset. So here we have a long exposure using an ND32 filter and a 2.5 minute shutter speed. With just the rubber feet on the grass, it still kept the tripod perfectly still. That meant I was able to keep the hill sharp whilst allowing the cloud to drift and give a sense of motion. In this type of scenario, where the center column isn't needed, I cannot fault this tripod at all. So I feel like I've had a great experience using this tripod and I'm now in a position to thoroughly review it. And so, would I recommend it for everyone? Well, possibly not. Is it perfect in every scenario? No. But then, what is? So who would I recommend it for? So this is for anyone who wants an ultra lightweight tripod, particularly if you're up and down hills, up and down mountains, photographing landscapes, things like that. This is fantastic. The weight is going to be really helpful. And it's because of that that I've decided I'm going to keep this tripod. Originally, my plan was to review it and send it back. But I've enjoyed using it so much that I'm going to keep it. And that's why you saw the little paid promotion banner. Because although Ulanzi haven't paid me any money, I am keeping the tripod. And in YouTube's policies, that counts as a paid promotion because I've received something, i.e. the tripod, for that. And I think this could be great for any of you who are in a similar situation to me. You know, I'm not as young as I used to be. I know you won't believe that. I don't look a day over 25. I can hear you all saying it. But seriously, as I'm getting older, I do need to think about my joints and my bones, and walking up and down hills and mountains doesn't get easier over time. So you do have to think about all of those physical things, and anything I can do to cut down the weight that I'm carrying is really helpful, particularly for me. I'm out shooting videos. I've always got two tripods with me, two cameras, two sets of batteries, loads of lenses, audio equipment, sometimes lighting, all sorts of other accessories. And if I can cut down on the weight a little bit, that's really helpful. So am I going to use this tripod in all scenarios? No, but it might become my dedicated tripod for videos, and I might use it when I'm walking long distances to photograph landscapes. And they're the kind of scenarios that I think you probably want to be thinking about. It is a travel tripod as well, so if you're going on holiday or somewhere that you want to keep the weight down but be able to keep a tripod with you that works pretty well, then this is a great solution because it's not going to take up much room in your luggage. You can strap it to your bag and hardly notice it's there. 1.1 kilograms is absolutely nothing. And its recommended retail price is £350. I note that right now, on the date that this video is being published, there is an offer on Amazon, so you can get it for a little bit cheaper than that. My nearest tripod to this, that is this kind of tripod, a travel type tripod, but a pro grade one, cost £470. That's my three-legged thing bookie. So fair bit more. And the nearest tripod that's directly comparable is the Peak Design tripod, which garnered a lot of attention this year. And they're remarkably similar in design. And that Peak Design tripod is £650. So it's £300 more than this. And this goes slightly higher. This is slightly lighter. And so I would have to say it's probably better value for money. I'm not going to go any further with the comparisons with the Peak Design one, though, because that's not fair. I've not tested that tripod. But just as a comparison of the stats, you'd have to say this is better value for money. So the only thing that Ulanzi have asked me to tell you is where you can buy it, and you can buy it directly from their website, but they prefer you to go and get it from Amazon. And I'll stick a link to the Amazon page in the description. It'll link you through to whichever Amazon site you use for your particular country. And I think they probably want you to use Amazon because the distribution that Amazon has is much quicker, and you'll receive your tripod a little bit quicker than if you bought it directly from them. But it's a great investment if you're looking for that lightweight tripod. So for more info about tripods, stability and gimbals, you might like to check out my tripods playlist just here. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.